Hi everyone, let's go through topic on differential calculus. We will go through introduction of differential calculus and find out derivatives using first principles. Differential calculus is a mathematical tool that helps in finding out or determining the rate of change of dependent variable with respect to an independent variable. What this means is, say you have this particular function or equation y is equal to x plus 2. There are two variables here, y and x. What are variables? They are unknowns, right? Now, the value of y changes based on the value of x. If x is 1, then y becomes 1 plus 2, which is 3. If x is 2, then y becomes 2 plus 2, which is 4. So based on the value of x, the value of y changes. So this y is called as a dependent variable. And x is called an independent variable. Y is called as dependent variable because the value of y is dependent on value of x. And x is independent. X is not dependent on any other value. So for example, if x is 3.01, then y becomes 3.01 plus 2, which is 5.01. Similarly, if x is 3.02, then y becomes 3.02 plus 2, which is 5.02. Differential calculus helps in finding out the rate of change. That is, as the x value changes, how does the value of y change? Now, what is an increment? Increment is nothing but the change in the values, the final value minus initial value. So here if you see, the increment is from 3.01 to 3.02. We changed here. Initially the x value was 3.01, then we changed to 3.02. So the difference between these two values is nothing but the increment. Similarly, the y values also change. It was 5.01. Later on, it becomes 5.02 when the x value changes. So the difference between these two becomes the increment. The way we denote increment is delta x. Delta x. Delta means a small change, small difference, right? That is what is delta. Delta y by delta x is nothing but rate of change of y with respect to x. That is, as the value of x changes, what is the value of y? So This delta y by delta x is called as rate of change. Derivative of function. What is derivative of function? Derivative of function is nothing but finding out the rate of change. Now let's take this particular function y is equal to f of x. F of x is nothing but any function. It can be x plus 2, x plus 3, any of these equations, anything, right? We call it as f of x. We are generalizing it, calling it as f of x. That is, it is some equation which has x in it. Now what we will do is, we will increase the value of x by a small amount, say delta x. So it will become x plus delta x. We are adding a small increase. So x plus delta x. Similarly, since we have increased the value of x, y value also will change. Y value also will increase, right? We'll call this as delta y. We'll say y has increased by delta y. This is the y increment. This is the x increment. So what will happen to the equation? Equation is y is equal to f of x, right? We'll increase f of x with small change, which is delta x. Because we are increasing here, y will also increase by delta y. Now, what I will do is, I just need to find delta y. I want to find how much of change has been done to y because of this change in x. So to find out that, I'll say delta y, I'll shift y this side, right? So delta y will be f of x plus delta x minus y. What is y? Y is f of x, right? So instead of y, I will substitute f of x. So it's going to be delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x minus y is f of x. So I'll substitute as f of x, right? Now, I need to find rate of change. What is rate of change? It is nothing but delta y by delta x. This is rate of change. So what I'll do, I'll divide both the sides by delta x. So it will be delta y by delta x. Both the sides I will do. So it will be x plus delta x minus f of x by delta x. Now this is the rate of change. Now I'll apply limit on both sides. That is, limit delta x tends to 0. That is, I need to find the rate of change for different values of x. I want to make a small change to this particular delta x. That change should be so small that it should be almost close to zero, not zero, very close to zero. That is why I'm calling it as limit delta x tends to zero, tends to zero. It is coming, approaching the difference, the change is approaching zero, but it is not zero. So, for example, I'll say delta x is equal to 0.00001, right? Right? So, and x is equal to 2. Say x is equal to 2. Delta x is 0.001. I'm adding delta x to x. That's what we did here, right? I'm adding delta x to x. And that number that I'm adding should be so small that it should be almost close to 0. 0.0001. So, that is what I'm telling here. Limit delta x tends to 0. So, I'll apply limit on both sides. Limit delta x tends to 0 of delta y by delta x is equal to limit delta x tends to 0. So now I've applied limit on both sides. So this value, the final limit value that you get, right, is called as the derivative or differential coefficient. Now I can write this as, I can write it in a short form. I can write it as dy by dx. Dy by dx. This entire thing, I can write it as dy by dx, which is equal to limit delta x tending to 0 f of x plus delta x minus f of x by delta x. Now, if I have to find the derivative at some value, some other value, say a, right? It could be any value. We are just generalizing and telling it some value a. Then you can write this formula as dy by dx is equal to limit x tending to a. This is some value. We can write it as f of x minus f of a by x minus a. X minus a is the difference between x and the value a. You find the difference here. And in the numerator, you have function of x and function of a. A is any value, right? So you can use any of these formulas. Dy by dx can also be written as y1 or y dash, or I can say d by dx of f of x. Now there is a theorem that states that every differentiable function is continuous, but every continuous function is not differentiable. We will not get into proof of this. It's a simple proof. We will go through this proof in another video. It's just a theorem. We will remember this. Also, differentiation. What is differentiation? The process of finding derivative is called as differentiation. We found this dy by dx, right? Dy by dx is limit x tending to a, f of x minus f of a by x minus a. This process of finding this derivative, that is dy by dx, is called as differentiation. It is also called as differentiation using first principles. If there's a question asking us to find derivative using first principles, then we will have to use this particular formula. Now let's take a few examples. Let's take this particular function where we have to differentiate a constant function using first principles. First principles means using this particular formula. Dy by dx is equal to limit delta x tending to 0, f of x plus delta x minus f of x by delta x. Now, what is a constant function? A constant function is nothing but a function which has just a constant. That is a number. Any number is a constant function. There is no variable. For example, say y is equal to 2, y is equal to 5. Y is equal to pi. Pi is nothing but it's a number. It is 3.14. Similarly, y is equal to e to the power pi. E is also a number, a constant number. So all these are called as constant functions because it's just a number. There is no x here. If you notice, there is no variable or there is no x here, right? So these functions are called as constant functions. Now, if I have given a function like this, what is the derivative? How do I find the derivative, right? What will be the value of the derivative? That's what we are going to prove using this particular formula. Y is equal to f of x, right? That's what we assumed. Y is equal to f of x. That is, y is a function of x, right? It is a function which has x in it. But we are calling this as a constant function, which means let's assume that constant is k. It can be any number, right? So we will generalize it and we'll assume that particular number is k. This particular constant is k. So Now I'll substitute in this particular formula. So y is equal to f of x, which is equal to k. dy by dx is equal to limit delta x tending to 0, x plus delta x, right? So wherever there is x, I have to put x plus delta x. Now, so y is equal to k, and this is nothing but f of x, right? This is a function. So f of x is equal to k here, right? Y is equal to f of x is equal to k here. So what will happen if I put x plus delta x? That is, what is x plus delta x? What will it be? There is no x at all. So there is nothing to substitute, right? It will be just be k itself. So I'll put k here. I'll substitute k here. What is f of x? F of x is k. So I'll put k by delta x. K minus k is 0. So it's going to be limit delta x tending to 0, 0. Therefore, dy by dx is limit x tending to 0 of 0. What is limit of a constant? Limit of a number? Limit of a number is 0 only. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to 0. So what this means is derivative, that is dy by dx, of any constant function, of any constant function is a 0. If they are asking us to find d by dx of, say, 2, then d by dx of 2 is 0. Now, let's take the second function. We need to differentiate x to the power n using first principles, which means we'll have to assume that y, which is nothing but function of x, which is equal to x to the power n. So we'll have to say, basically, y is equal to x to the power n. That's what we are telling. We need to find the derivative of this particular function. So we'll use this formula. We'll substitute here. Dy by dx is equal to limit delta x tending to 0. What is x plus delta x? Instead of x, I'll have to put x plus delta x. That is, f of x is equal to x to the power n. Y is equal to f of x is equal to x to the power n. I need to find f of x plus delta x, which means instead of x, I have to put x plus delta x. Instead of x, I'll put x plus delta x. That's all. I'll write this as x plus delta x to the power n. What is f of x? F of x is x to the power n, right? Upon delta x. If you notice this, right? This is of the form limits theorem. What does limits theorem say? Limit x tending to a, x to the power n minus a to the power n by x minus a is equal to n into a to the power n minus 1. This is limits theorem. Now, if you notice this is of the same format. Here, this term is like x to the power n and this is like a to the power n. The denominator has to be of the form x minus a. That is nothing but it should be like this, x plus delta x minus x. Right? This we assumed as x and this we assumed as a. Correct? This is like x and this is like a. So, we should have x plus delta x minus x in the denominator to apply this theorem. So, what we will do? We'll add and subtract x. Right? We'll add and subtract x. Then we will get this particular form. So, we'll add x and subtract x. So, now this is of this form. Correct? Now, we'll apply the theorem. So, what do we get? We'll get n. What is n? N itself into a. What is a? A is x. N minus 1. So we got n into x to the power n minus 1. So dy by dx is equal to n into x to the power n minus 1. So this is the derivative of x to the power n. Derivative of x to the power n is n into x to the power n minus 1. Now let's differentiate sine x, another function, using first principles, right? So what we will have to do, what is the first step? Y is equal to f of x is equal to sine x, right? This is what we need to differentiate. So this is nothing but dy by dx is equal to, let's put that formula first, delta x tending to 0, f of x plus delta x minus f of x upon delta x. So dy by dx is equal to limit delta x tending to 0, f of x is equal to sine x. So what is f of x plus, what is f of x plus delta x? Instead of x, I have to put x plus delta x. So it will be sine of x plus delta x. So let me substitute sine of x plus delta x minus, what is f of x? Sine x upon delta x. Now I have to use the transformation formulae, right? What is the transformation formula? If you notice, this is like sine c minus sine d. What is sine c minus sine d? It is 2 cos c plus d by 2 into sine c minus d by 2, right? Now using this formula, we'll substitute here. So we'll get dy by dx is equal to limit delta x tending to 0 sine of x plus delta x minus, so this is like c and this x is like d, so it will be 2 cos c is x plus delta x plus d is x by 2 into sine x plus delta x minus x by 2 by delta x. So this is going to be dy by dx is equal to limit delta x tending to 0 to cos 2x plus delta x by 2 into sine delta x by 2. This x and this x will get cancelled upon delta x. Now again we can apply limits formula here, right? What is limit? Limit x tending to 0 sine x by x is equal to 1, right? We have this limits theorem. We'll apply this. To apply this, that is, we need to apply it here, right? To apply this, we need by 2 here, right? We need by 2 here. Only then we can apply this. So what we will do, we'll multiply and divide by 2. If we multiply and divide by 2, you'll get this in this form. So if I apply limit to this, I have to apply limit to this also, right? So this constant, I can put it as is 2 into, instead of delta x, I'll substitute 0 here. Instead of delta x, I'll substitute 0. So it will be 2 cos 2x by 2 into limit of this is 1 into 1. And then we have this 2 here, right? We'll have by 2, right? Sine delta x by 2 by delta x by 2 is going to become 1. And then we're left with this 2, which is here 2. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. This 2 and 2 will get cancelled. We're left with cos x. So dy by dx is cos x for sine x. So derivative of sine x is cos x. You can also write this as d of dx of y. What is y? Y is sine x. Correct? Y is sine x. So we can write this d by dx of sine x is cos x. We will cover some more examples in the next video. If you have liked this video, do press a like and share it. Thank you.